We're good? Well, good morning, everyone. We are here today to announce that the 49th Investigative Grand Jury has voted on and approved presentments for 5 individuals who have committed sexual abuse against children throughout Pennsylvania. Let me begin first by thanking the members of the Office of Attorney General who have assisted with this case. First Deputy Attorney General James Donahue, Deputy Chief of Staff Kirsten Hyde, Executive Deputy Attorney General Michelle Walsh, Chief Deputy District Attorney Ron Eisenberg, Chief Deputy Attorney General Chris Jones, Assistant Chief Deputy Attorney General Dan Dye, to my left, Supervising Agent Doug Hilliard, Deputy Attorney General Alicia Warner, Special Agent Jimmy Muma, and Special Agent Steve Adamus. Let me also take a moment to thank the citizens, the men and women who served on the investigative grand jury. They took their time, they listened to difficult evidence, they evaluated that evidence, and they returned these charges. Finally, let me thank those that came forward, the survivors of child sexual abuse. They had a courageous voice. They came and they told us what had happened to them. And they make our community safer. We would not be here today without them. These cases, as all of them are disturbing and sad. But this one, in particular, digs deeper. Because in this case, all of the defendants and all of the victims come from the same religious organization, the Jehovah Witnesses. Some of these defendants even use their faith communities to prey upon the victims, and others had to look no further than their own families. The details of these crimes are hard to listen to, but make no mistake about it. This office will do absolutely everything we can to hold these men accountable for what they did to these innocent children. I'd like to take you back to the beginning, to the background on this case. Some of you may recall that in October, this office announced criminal charges in 4 cases in 4 different Pennsylvania counties against 4 members of the Jehovah Witness organization for sexual assault and exploitation of children. That investigation started as a resource referral from a local district attorney's office. And when we received it, we began to investigate that case and gather evidence. Through that investigation, we learned of several incidents of sexual assault committed by members of Jehovah Witnesses congregation. After a 3-year investigation, hundreds of hours of grand jury testimony, and dozens of witnesses, we filed charges against those 4 individuals. And at that time, when we announced those charges against the 4 individuals, we asked for people to come forward, for anybody who had something similar like this happen to them, to reach out, to call our hotline, and come to us. And many courageous survivors came forward and called the hotline. So as a result of our ongoing investigation, and the individuals that reached out to us on our hotline, we are here today to announce these charges. I want to thank the honorable men and women that helped us apprehend these individuals, the Pennsylvania State Police Butler Barracks, the Ross Township Police, the Ketchum City Police in Idaho, the Braddock Hills Police Department, and all members of law enforcement that assisted us and continue to assist us in this endeavor. Now I'm going to go through each case individually, but I really invite you to take the time to look at the presentments. They will be available to all of you, and they have more detail than I will recount this morning. Let me begin first with Mark Brown, 65, of Allegheny County. It is alleged that Brown repeatedly sexually abused two sisters for whom he was the legal guardian at the time. They were between the ages of 10 and 13 years old when this happened. They testified to being assaulted in the shower and other parts of the house that they shared with Brown when they were young girls. He threatened the older sister that if she did anything to stop him, or if she told anyone, he would sexually abuse her younger sister. When in reality, that was already happening. He was already doing that to her. She didn't know it. Brown is charged with aggravated indecent assault, endangering the welfare of children, and corruption of minors. The next case is Raymond Schultz, 74, of Beaver County. It is alleged that Schultz repeatedly sexually assaulted his own granddaughters when they were between the ages of 5 and 10 years old. Both girls testified to being assaulted while visiting Schultz at his home. The girls' parents trusted him, asked him to watch them. And he betrayed that trust in the most horrendous way. He's been charged with aggravated indecent assault, endangering the welfare of children, and corruption of minors. The next case is Abamil Valentine Matos, 42, of Lancaster County. It is alleged that Matos abused a 15-year-old girl who at the time was half his age, claiming that he intended to marry her. He met this victim in 2009 at a Jehovah Witness event that brought together multiple congregations. The congregation was aware of his romantic interest in the girl, noting that they would approve of it if certain conditions were met, including the presence of a chaperone and the commitment to eventually marry her. Matos' interest in the minor quickly turned sexual, and he began sending inappropriate photos and convinced her to meet him alone, no chaperone. During these meetings, he sexually assaulted her. He's been charged with indecent assault, indecent exposure, endangering the welfare of children, and corruption of minor. The next case is Kevin Isevich, 51, of Butler County. It is alleged that he sexually assaulted a member of his family when she was just 9 years old. The victim recalled playing with her cousins when he pulled her into his bedroom and assaulted her. The abuse only stopped that day when the defendant's wife returned home. He's been charged with rape, aggravated indecent assault, endangering the welfare of children, and corruption of minors. The next case is Norman Avalez, 44, of Lancaster County. It is alleged that he sexually assaulted three minors who were between the age of 5 and 10 years old. He was an elder in the Jehovah Witness congregation, which allowed him to build a rapport with members. He gained the trust of several parents, including his own relatives, which gave him extensive access to young girls in the congregation. He was trusted to babysit and even act as a guardian to one of his victims. The grand jury heard testimony from two of his victims that described that he groped their bodies and assaulted them. A third victim testified to frequent unwanted touching, including groping. He has been charged with aggravated indecent assault, endangering the welfare of children, and corruption of minors. We have a duty to protect children in Pennsylvania. These children deserve a community where they can grow, play, learn, and pray, and not be preyed upon. Our office will never stop working to bring justice for those who have been victimized. We will continue to investigate and prosecute anyone who takes advantage and harms the most vulnerable in our society. We urge anyone who has any information about any of these cases or who has had a similar experience to reach out to us. Tell us what happened. We will be here. On a personal note, and because this is my first announcement of this nature, I want to underscore what I just said. It is my solemn pledge that I will be here to help survivors. Much of my career spent as a prosecutor prior to joining this office was focused on prosecuting those that sexually abuse children. I'm deeply aware of the impact these kind of cases have on the victims, have on the victim's family, and it is our duty to seek justice, to be their voice, to hold these individuals accountable so that they may have some hope of more moving forward in life. And so I say, again, to anyone with any information regarding similar allegations of sexual assault, I urge you to please contact our hotline, 888-538-8541. We will not hesitate to take action. Thank you. Sure.
So from what I understand, Jehovah's Witness has its own internal judicial system. Have you investigated if they were aware of this, if they looked into it, and if so, will you be looking at the organization for any charges?
This is an ongoing investigation. Any other questions? Yes.
Can you speak to the nature of some of these individuals, as you said, were dealing with people in authority, or they thought were in authority, dealing with the fact that these are adults that obviously know what they are doing, but in some cases the children are dealing with people they think should be trusted or they don't know how to otherwise interact with?
Well, I can tell you that unfortunately, as you probably know, in child abuse cases, it's very frequent that the individuals who prey on children do so in a way that they build trust with the adults around these children such that they trust them and allow them access, never imagining that actually they're predators. That's a frequent thing that we see in these cases. Yes?
Were the two men from Lancaster County from the same congregation, the same group?
They were associated with the Lancaster East and West congregations.
Any other questions? Well, thank you all for coming. We appreciate it.